Guys, it's Victoria Wohunda from the BBC Africa, and I have got a surprise for you. We've been telling you this was going to happen, and it's finally happening. And look who's joined me, Amina Yuguda, the BBC Komla Dumor Award winner for 2017.
Hello, Victoria.
Hi, welcome and congratulations.
Thank you very much.
I mean, it was revealed today at 4 o'clock in the morning. That's when everybody knew. But you've known for a while. How did you react when you found out?
Well, I was so excited. I mean, this was the biggest news I've heard in a very long time. So you can imagine. It's like your birthday, your any day that's exciting for you in your life, if you can think about it. It's all of those days rolled into one. So it was really exciting. I was so happy.
So did you get a phone call? Did you get an email? Tell us, how did you get this news? Everybody will want to know.
Actually, I was at work when I was told, and I got a phone call. But I wasn't allowed to tell anyone. So, you know, I was at work trying to concentrate, and I get this phone call, and they say, well, we have something to tell you, but you can't tell anyone. I wanted to scream. Like, I had so much
inside
of me.
You couldn't even tell your mother or anybody?
No, at that point, I couldn't tell anyone.
Oh, my
God. So, after the phone call, I went outside, and I called my mum. She was the first person I called, and she was screaming on the other end, and I was screaming. It was just so crazy. Like, it was a wonderful day. I'll always remember it for the rest of my life.
Yeah. Now, guys, again, this is Amina Yuguda, the BBC Komla Dumor Award winner for 2017. And you're watching us now live on Facebook. Remember the drill. You put the questions down in the comments, and I will read them to her, and then she can answer them to you. So while we get that going, we just want to know, who is Amina Yuguda? Tell us more about yourself.
Okay. I'm a Fulani girl from Yola. Yola is a town in northeast Nigeria. I'm breaking it down for people who have never heard of Yola. So, northeast Nigeria, Adamawa State, and then Yola. I'm a Fulani girl, I'm from there. And I've lived most of my life in Lagos, but I do say my home is Yola. And I moved back to Yola fully for work in 2012, and that's when this whole journey began. I started out with radio. I was just hosting radio shows, and then one day while I was on the air in radio, one of my managers called me and said, well, who are you? You should be on TV. And so and over the next couple of weeks, I got transferred from radio to TV, and I started reading the news. And as a news reader, you know, there's not really much you can do. If you're a news reader, you're just in the studio reading the news that other people, you know, send in. So I wanted to do more.
You wanted to be out in the field.
I wanted to hear from real people and tell their stories. So I started a program that I call The Real Africa. And if you're in Yola, you probably would have seen this program. It runs on the station. Well, by the way, my home station is Gotel Communications in Yola. They groomed me. All of my teachers in Gotel, because I consider everyone I've ever come in contact with at the course of my life a teacher, because I've learned something from every experience I've ever had, good or bad. So all of my teachers in Yola helped me, you know, develop this program about normal people in Yola living normal lives. And there's so much culture and tradition in that small town. But I realized all the news we were hearing coming out of Nigeria and the North was usually things about Boko Haram and negative things. I wanted to show to the world there's a beautiful group of people living in this small town, and there's so much going on there that everyone should know about. And that was what the story was about on The Real Africa.
You actually bring in something that I wanted to mention. We've gotten already some comments and questions, and there's actually somebody, Awal Mohammed, he says, you know, how do you feel being the first to win the award from northeastern Nigeria, where Boko Haram has actually caused more damages to schools, to hospitals, forcing many children out of school and people dying?
Well, I would compare it to, you know, when they say chicken soup for the soul. This is chicken soup for Yola. Everyone thinks, you know, if you watch the news, you probably think every single day in northeast Nigeria. There's a bomb going off every single day. But that's not the case. Mm. There are beautiful people with a beautiful tradition, and they're keeping true to their Asian customs. So it's not all negatives coming out of northeast Nigeria. I live there, you know, I work there. So there's so many beautiful things that come out of the region. It's not just negative things.
Yeah. Guys, again, thank you so very much. We are live on Facebook. I'm Victoria Wonguna with BBC Africa, and Amina Yuguda, the new Komla Dumor Award winner for this year. Keep your comments, keep your questions coming. I am seeing them, so if you see me looking down on the phone, it's not because I don't want to look at Amina, or I'm just ignoring you, because I'm trying to keep up with the questions and all these that are coming. Now, I've got a couple of my own questions, and you know, this is an award that is named after Komla Dumor, our the BBC's presenter. Now, he wanted to tell the African story, pretty much the same as you were telling with, you know, True Africa. This is what you do. How do you tell the African story to a wider audience?
Well, first of all, I really want to say a very big thank you to Komla. He opened up Africa to the world. You know, he was such a wonderful person. I didn't know him personally, but I felt like I knew him. Every time I watched him on TV, I felt like my friend was talking to me about things I already knew. And he was showing me even more angles and different stories about Africa. So, I mean, this is honoring his legacy the right way. You know, bringing out journalists from Africa and giving them a global platform. Well, you see, today, if you're watching an international news carrier, you'd think Africa is poverty-stricken. There's nothing works, in essence, in Africa. That's what you would think if you're watching most international stories. And that's because they choose to report the things that they think is relevant to them. Now, you see, the narrative will only remain relevant to them because that's what favors them. If we take hold of our stories by telling it ourselves, then we get a better portrayal in the international platform. So I do think Komla started something really beautiful, and we are hopefully going to continue that legacy. I and the two chairwomen before me, you know, because I like to say in Nigeria, we like to have chairmen for everything. You'd have a group of people and one person is a chairman. So we're having more chairwomen coming out. Nancy Kachungira and Didi Akinyelure, who's my Nigerian sister, they've started doing a beautiful work, you know, honoring Komla's memory. And I hope to sort of fit into that shoe. It's a really large shoe for me to fit into, but I'm going to try my best to tell more of Africa's story to the world.
Yeah. Now, you mentioned Nancy Kachungira and Didi Akinyelure, who are the other winners for 2015 and 2016. What advice did they give you?
Well, Nancy, I'm going to start. Okay, I start with Didi. We talked, and what I liked the most about the conversation we had was that she said to me, if you have any problems whatsoever, if there's anything you need at the drop of a hat, just let me know and I will come to your rescue. And so, you know, that was very helpful for me because
she's walked in those shoes before.
Yes,
she knows.
You know, she had the experience of what was happening here before I came here. So she, you know, offered her services for me to be my guide, to help me through the maze that is the BBC. If you haven't been to the BBC before, it's really huge. I mean, new broadcasting house is very huge. You could get lost. I did get lost. Yeah, I did get lost and almost got into trouble on my second day, because all of the buildings sort of look alike, the floors sort of look alike, so it's easy to get lost in the maze that the BBC is. But people like Nancy, Didi, Emily, Casriel, in fact, I think everyone here is like a family. They all helped me find my way. And Nancy sat with me and said to me, look, calm down. It is all going to work out in the end. So they helped me through the process from the first day, you know, to always encouraging me, saying to me that if you have any questions, just come to me. So that was very helpful for me.
Yeah. Guys, once again, I'm Victoria Wamunda with the BBC Africa. We are Facebook Live with Amina Yuguda. She is the 2017 Komla Dumor Award winner. Thank you so very much for your comments. We have something from Caroline Kamui, says, I'm watching from Zambia. Mired Kebede Alboy says, oh, that guy was a joy. I guess he's talking about Komla,
yeah,
as you mentioned. Somebody's from Tanzania, Frederick Linga, and Salisu Musa Ndangata says, congrats, sister. I wish you all the best for life.
Thank you.
Yeah, you mentioned a bit how big the BBC is. It is really, truly big. And not just in terms of, you know, one of the biggest news organizations in the world or the size of it, but how have you found it so far, besides getting lost?
Okay, well, there's a backstory here. When I was coming to the BBC at first, there's one thing you need to understand about how we perceive the BBC in northern Nigeria. The BBC is king. You know, everyone turns to listen to what the BBC is saying for ideas and what policy direction the national government in Nigeria will take. In fact, the BBC is sort of an oracle, because if you need any, if you have any questions, you'll find the answers on the BBC. That's what most people think in northern Nigeria. We follow the BBC every single minute. So at the back of my mind, I had that. So I was coming in here to learn. I really wanted to learn. I wanted every single opportunity that I had here to be a learning opportunity, a teachable moment. And so far, I have been learning so much, so much. From the way everything is organized, to the storytelling, to the way people manage relationships. Because, you know, if you think about it, you spend more of your life in an office, in a work environment, more than anywhere else if you're a working woman. So the way that the workflow is organized and the relationship between people is so, it's just wonderful, you know. So I've learned so much from that, and
A couple of questions from our Facebook viewers and listeners. Now we have somebody who is in Pakistan, and she wants to ask you, what message would you give to a female journalist in Pakistan?
Well, you see, I think the story in Pakistan is sort of similar to the story in northern Nigeria. We are a very conservative society in northern Nigeria. So it's sort of a glass ceiling that you have to shatter through, you know? If you're a woman trying to be a journalist, you have to just sift through all of the noise and focus on what you want to achieve for yourself. If anyone's trying to bring you down, think of it as a reflection on their character, not yours. You know, think about it like a race, because this whole life is a race. People are out for themselves only. So do not think about negativity. Focus on your goal and always, always learn from every single situation you find yourself in. There's a lesson to be learned, good or bad. Every experience counts.
If you're just joining us, we are on Facebook Live. I'm Victoria Wamunda of BBC Africa. Amina Yuguda, the Komla Dumor Award winner for 2017. Just to wrap up a little bit of what she said, if you just joined us, how she was excited when she found out. She called her mom. She wanted to scream to the world, but couldn't tell until today. So today's the reveal. Today she's here. You've been congratulating her from across the world. I mean, I'm seeing things from China, from Canada,
wow,
from everywhere. So, you know, thank you so very much for all this. But before we let Amina go, because she's busy and we are very privileged to have you now on this time, what stories can we expect to see from you in the future?
Well, spoiler alert, there's going to be lots of stories about Africa. Obviously, I'm from Africa, and I do believe that there's so much more of the continent that the world needs to know about. We're not all poverty-stricken people. We're not all living in some jungle in Africa. Like some people think it's just one country. No. We're very progressive.
Are you telling people that there are more countries?
There are 54 countries.
Well,
so, you know, there's so much. And the culture, the traditions, it's very rich. You know, we have so many stories to tell, and I will be bringing them to you. And before we go, anyone watching would assume that I'm all about just girls and girl education, but I do want to say something about my father, who's always been my biggest fan. From day one, he always taught me the value of hard work. I can remember one of my earliest memories of him was him driving me to school and saying to me, well, you need to work really hard at school, read your books. You know, he always pushed me to be better than I am. So it's not all feminism coming out of Northeast Nigeria or Nigeria. There are good people everywhere. In every situation, we have good people and we have exceptions to that rule. So I do want to say that Nigeria is winning. There's so many things coming out of Nigeria that would make the country look terrible right now, but it's a beautiful country. And drop your preconceived notions about the country aside. It's a beautiful country.
Well, guys, you've heard it, and we're getting some comments, people saying big up Nigeria, I guess, yeah, big up also Africa.
Nigeria and Africa,
and,
of course.
You know, big up for Komla Dumor, who led with great example, and many of us are aspiring to be what he was, to walk in his shoes. And thank you so much for watching. We appreciate the comments. We appreciate the questions. Keep them coming. And if you want to know more about the award, we are going to post a link to the website for more information later on. I'm Victoria Uwohunda, and I had the pleasure of speaking with Amina Yuguda, the new Komla Dumor Award winner for 2017. Thank you, guys. Thank you.
Bye.